In this lesson, we are going to use infrared transmitter or remote and infrared receiver to detect when the key is pressed. We can take action or turn on a buzzer so we detect the signal from remote. And we are going to learn how to take action when a button is pressed, for example, power, turn off, on. Welcome to Arduino course by Robojax. This course is based on SunFounder 3-in-1 Arduino kit sold on Amazon. Everything that you learn in this course is included in this kit. The course comes with tons of components and projects, all with instruction and video for smart car and other projects that you can use for school or home automation. You can purchase it from sunfounder.com. The kit also comes with full documentation, code download, learning projects with full explanation, wiring diagram, and the code that you can download. The link to purchase the kit and documentation is below the video in the description. In this lesson, we're going to use this infrared receiver where we will transmit some code using this transmitter. And the transmitter is located in here. So this will release the infrared, which we cannot see, but this sensor can see it, and we will detect which key is pressed. The first thing we do is there is a battery installed here, and when I remove it, the battery is now activated. To check the battery, we just need to push this piece. Just push this the other side, and then this can be removed. Here, this is the battery, and the battery is CR2025. This is a 3-volt battery. This plastic was just blocking it from usage, so the battery would last longer. And this is the code under more syntax, 511.2, and here 511, and then 511.2 is infrared receiver. We have an infrared receiver that has power supply, 5 volts, ground, and the left pin is the receiver or the signal that we receive. And here, this is the wiring. It's very simple. From the right, it goes to 5 volts, the middle to ground, and the left pin, we are connecting it to pin 11. And here, the receiver has a bump here. Make sure it's facing you. From the right, this goes to 5 volts. The middle pin goes to ground. And the left pin, which is signal, it goes to pin 11 in this code. Now, first, let's install the library. For remote, click on Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries. On this screen, type IR or EMOTE, IR Remote. Just wait a few seconds, and here you will see IR Remote. Click Install, wait for the installation to complete, and close. Now, to open the code, click on File, Open, 3-in-1 Kit, and then Learning Project. And 511IR, and select 511IR and open it. And here is the code. If you pay attention, this is the first time that you see another tab. So in this tab, we have series of decode values certain value for each. For example, we have this value. Each value is corresponding to something, plus minus 9 US cycle play pause. So these are the codes that we are receiving from remote. But here we have included the library in this line, and we have defined pin 11 as receive pin. And then from this IR receive, IR remote, we create the receive pin and pass the receive pin, and the decode result will be available in here. Inside the setup, we are initializing the serial monitor, and this, and then you using the object that we created in here, we use enable IRN, so we can start receiving. Inside the loop, this function is getting the decode, and this result is passed as an object. This result is from the decode result. So this decode result is also part of this library. We create an object called result, and we pass it to this function, which decodes. If the result is okay, then we use the decode value. We get the result, the value from there, and result.value, we pass it. And if we don't get error, then that's our value, will be printed. If we don't get the code equal to error, otherwise it has something useful, and then it says resume. So this decode value is a function which is in the same folder. And here, if we go to learning projects and 5.11, you will see that we have this file, decoder key value.uno. So we have two files. This is automatically included because it's in the same folder. So this will read it for us. Let me upload the code. Now I've opened the serial monitor. So here is the remote. As you can see, we read some function, some text. Let me show you. It says the function decode and result is deprecated. It may not work as expected. Just use decode without parameter and infrared decoder will receive it with a field name. It says deprecated. If it doesn't work, use it like that, but don't worry, it's working. So here I'm pressing, let's say, power. And as you can see, we have decoded power. Let me click this mute. Play pause. This is what? Backward, forward, minus, plus, zero, and then equalizer, cycle or repeat. And here is a code that I have written to take action when a key is pressed. First, we have defined a buzzer pin, pin 2. And inside the setup, we are defining using pin mode the buzzer pin as output. So this must be inside setup. And inside the loop, here is what we take action. This is a portion that I have added. This will have the value, and I use that in here, and I said if this value is equal power. If the power key is pressed, then using digital write, the buzzer pin should be high. So the buzzer, which is connected to that buzzer pin, pin 2, will be turned on. Else, if it is not, if the value is something else, then turn it off or set it low. As simple as that. And here I've added this buzzer. The right pin is long. I've connected it using red wire from positive to pin 2. And the left pin, the pin that's the other side, has been connected to ground. Now let's open the serial monitor. Serial monitor is open here. And here is my buzzer. Let me press one or other keys. As you can see, it says mute. Now let's press power. So buzzer is running. If I press it again, it will not change because it's the same value. You have to do something else. Power or other button. Perfectly working. This is ultimate infrared project for Arduino. We're going to learn how to detect any remote using Arduino so we can take action when you press a key to do something. Then we're going to use Arduino as a transmitter or as a remote so we can turn on and off a TV or other devices that needs infrared. Next project, we are going to control an AC bulb or a relay, so you can control AC bulb or DC bulb or load, whatever you have. Next project, we are going to like this. When I press it, it rotates now right, stop it, and then rotate it left. And final project will be to control a servo motor using infrared.